Miss Stilling, you and your husband experienced a very special after-death contact, that is, an after-death contact with your deceased dog. Would you tell me what were the events leading up to this experience? Yes, by all means. Her name is Joni, and we got her in 2002. At the time, our youngest son was still living together with us in our home, and we, well, I in particular, felt from the very beginning that this dog was a special soul. So Joni was with us, and of course, I didn't really know anything about dogs. I just knew I loved her, and Joni was like, well, sometimes there were circumstances where it was not easy to raise the dog, yet it was her nature that she did everything for us so that all went well. Moreover, we were still working at the time, and my youngest son was at school, so Joni had to be alone as a very small dog, and that's why I wondered whether she would be able to cope with the situation. Actually, Joni adapted so well to us out of sheer joy that she was allowed to be with us, that there was never a problem. She was such a smart dog. She died last year, and she was so very, well, shall I say, she just felt so many things, so that I always thought to myself, how can a dog know my thoughts, and often at exactly the right moment? So even though we were working about 8 hours a day, when I went out the front door in the morning, she understood it. When I used to say, bye-bye, we're back very soon. And then when occasionally I was thinking about whether I might take Joni with me to work today, and whether this day, the situation was appropriate for the children there at school, she understood this thought, stood up, and came with me to the front door. It was really incredible sometimes. Well, seen on the whole, Joni was a very clever, a very fine, and unimaginably wise dog. Also, with regard to the things that have sometimes changed, and so she was actually like a guardian angel. How old was Joni when she died? 16. And it was Joni's birthday last week. She would have turned 17. Mr. Tutsch, how did you experience the dog? I too had no previous experience with dogs, at least not as house pets. And sometimes I was just simply amazed that there was such a thing, you understand, for example, Joni understood that you don't need a leash when going for a walk, when she would spontaneously move close to us. And before crossing a road, she stayed on the sidewalk waiting there until we came and said to her that she could cross now. I found it fascinating that something like this is possible at all. People would say that one would have a good social understanding. In this case, now applied to dogs, there was never any trouble. She always behaved in a, shall I say, de-escalating way in order to avoid conflicts completely. In fact, there were none at all. It had always been my problem in the past that many a time I had trouble with dogs. And I think that this creature settled in really very well indeed. And as I said, you just had to think something and the dog knew what you wanted. Mr. Tutsch, how did you experience contact with Joni after her death? We had come to the realization that Joni was gradually showing signs of aging, and we just wanted to spare our dog any unnecessary suffering. Joni was already 16, so we put her to sleep with an injection. We were, of course, deeply, deeply saddened about it, because we felt that there was a being in our home that we were now missing, and we were alone. About 8 to 14 days after this event, it happened that I had to get up in the middle of the night, and somehow I felt thirsty, So as our bedroom is on the first floor and the kitchen is on the ground floor, and the way there leads down a somewhat difficult staircase, narrow and smooth, which you can actually only navigate fully conscious. And when I went through the living room, and having gone down the stairs, I felt something behind me. And then, turning around halfway, I saw Joni standing there. That was 8 days after her death. Yes, she was standing there and looking at me with a look dogs use to look at someone. It seemed to me that she had somewhat sad eyes. Dogs, in some way, used to have this kind of faithful and sad look. And that's how Joni was, standing there, but quite deliberately, not with her tail between her legs or anything like that, but really as if she wanted to say, I am sad that I'm dead, but I'm still with you. And so she was standing there, and it took me some time until I understood this, whereupon it became clear to me what I had experienced. And I thought, this can't be true. So you saw your dog very clearly. Yes, yes, indeed. I saw Joni very clearly. And the thought, this just can't be true, kept running through my mind. This really isn't possible. It also felt for me that this experience lasted for half an eternity. This was at least the impression that I was given. And with this thought in mind, I turned around to continue on my way to the kitchen. But I turned around again while I was walking, and Joni was no longer there. But my mind was filled with what I saw. I even looked at my watch. It was about 3 a.m. Then I went back to bed. My wife was sleeping, at least she didn't move, and I was dreaming a bit shortly before falling asleep, still thinking about what I had experienced. But actually, I only became aware of this the next morning when my wife told me at breakfast what she had experienced. I don't think that I told you that when we had breakfast, but when I woke up, when I realized that he was awake, I said, Hermann, you won't believe what happened to me this night. I felt Joni in my arms, and it was like this. And then I told him about my dream. Actually, it was something like an absurd dream. As it was in our garden, it was somewhere in the garden, but there were wild animals in the garden. So there was an agreement with Joni that she would stay in a small shed until I brought her food, which I did, and I said, Joni, now everything is well again. There are no other animals in the garden. And I was really happy to hug her. And I said to her, sweetie, now you can come along with me, or something similar to that. And then I carried her in my arms. She was really a heavy dog, but I was holding her in my arms. And I walked over to the house, and I had her on my lap. And that was so unimaginable, because I woke up in this situation. I felt this pulsating, warm body, the little head that she always used to put aside so sweetly. And when she snuggled up to me, everything was so real, her body warmth and the feeling of her soft fur. And so I woke up and then I thought, this can't be possible. This just can't be true, because Joni is dead. It took me a few minutes to understand that I really had had this experience. For whatever reason, she was in my arms. And she was really there. But actually, it can't be possible. And so I was lying in bed awake for a very long time. And because I wondered if all this had come about in order to comfort us, and that Joni wanted to tell us, don't be so sad, I'm still there somehow, just maybe in a different form of being. And then I looked at the clock because I thought, well, because I couldn't fall asleep right away, and that was shortly before 3 a.m. And so the next morning, I told Hermann what I had experienced. And when I said, "Hermann, that was around 3 a.m., he started telling me, I don't remember if it was during breakfast, that Joni was last night in our living room. That was really incredible. It wasn't imagination. It was the beneficial physical feeling of truly holding a dog in your arms for a while." What has been the significance of this experience for you?
Well, for me, this experience became a bit of a confirmation of what I've been dealing with again and again for over 20 years, that animals also have a soul. And when considering the conversations you have with people saying, "Oh, now don't overdo it, it was just a dog," and also saying this when I would say that it's so hard to bear that she was now over 16 years old and would soon be gone. So it was sometimes hard and bitter for me that she would be gone. And then I decided that I don't necessarily have to talk about it. This experience with Joni was confirmation to me that the soul after death is still there for a while. This was how I felt it. And that is the same with animals as with humans. And that was then my inner attitude. And because Joni has given us these signs of her presence, as if she wanted to comfort us a little bit, we had the chance to put her in a beautiful tomb in this garden, which belongs to us. And the fact that we're allowed to bury her there is surely a further sign of our appreciation for her. And it was as if Joni simply wanted to let us know that she is always deeply connected with us. You know that I am still there in some different form of being, but yet very close to you. And due to all these impressions, I find my feelings confirmed. Mr. Tutsch, before this experience, did you believe that animals would live on after their death? No, I couldn't really imagine that. It was, anyway, difficult for me to imagine that something like this could ever happen. Because you hear a lot about phenomena like this. That's true. But you just don't find the necessary explanation of it all. But this experience has indeed made me rather pensive. Firstly, I was really very surprised that it is my animal, and as well that an animal can appear to someone at all. We have heard many times that the deceased appeared to people occasionally. And I was also surprised about the temporal concurrence of the experience of my wife with my own experience. What I mean is that this really happened the same night and without our previous arrangement. I was really stunned when my wife told me that she had experienced something similar. And for me, it really means now that this somehow could not have been a coincidence. And thirdly, what impressed me the most was that I was fully aware of the reality of all this, and that without the slightest doubt, I am completely convinced that this really happened. But when afterwards my logical way of thinking prevailed, everything was suddenly gone. And for me, as a physicist, this is actually nothing new, because today we know that the methods of measuring may influence results. And I think that the brain is able to dispel certain things that, due to our rational logic, simply cannot be possible. Well, all of this was very thought-provoking for me, and I'm definitely not yet at the end with this, because there are for sure still some things that can change my view of life in this respect. And this experience was certainly the trigger for that. Miss Stilling and Hermann, thank you so very much for the interview.